Hello, folks. Craig with you here at the Railroad Museum of Pennsylvania. Check out this interesting yellow car. This is the Cumberland Valley Railroad combination car and is another unique piece in the museum's collection. It was built by the Cumberland Valley Railroad in 1855 when Franklin Pierce was president. Now, there's a name you certainly don't hear every day. Be that as it may, in North American parlance, a combination car, most often simply referred to as a combine, is a type of railroad car which has sections for both passengers and freight. In this case, the freight portion was for baggage. To maintain the security of the baggage area and to allow passengers or crew to pass through, an unusual walkway is located alongside the baggage compartment, which you can see to the right. This feature may have been added later after the car was built. The Cumberland Valley Railroad was one of Pennsylvania's earliest railroads, chartered in 1835. This charter authorized a rail line to cover the 50 miles between Chambersburg and Bridgeport, Pennsylvania. You might know Bridgeport today as Lemoyne, which is on the west bank of the Susquehanna River across from Harrisburg. This line was completed in 1837. In these early days, there was a lot of economic competition between states. As Pennsylvania was the nation's breadbasket at the time, this railroad was built as a way of diverting shipments away from Baltimore and to Philadelphia merchants instead, as a way to help bolster the economy in the Commonwealth and not in Maryland. The line gained great importance during the Civil War, shuttling Union troops and supplies toward the front lines in the South. These actions made the railroad a target when Confederate soldiers set fire to the railroad's main locomotive and car shops in Chambersburg. While we don't know for sure if this combine played an actual role in the Civil War, it was deemed important enough to eventually become part of the Pennsylvania Railroad's own relic collection and was displayed at numerous expositions and public events. Now let's end with this fun fact. This car is believed to be one of the oldest surviving wooden passenger cars in the United States. My friends, once again, I want to thank you for joining me here at the Railroad Museum of Pennsylvania for this brief spotlight tour.